For Mining Review Africa, it's Chantal Kotze. I'm at DRC Mining Week interviewing Randgold Resources CEO Mark Bristow. Hi, Mark.
Hello.
Can we please discuss the mining code? It's been a very, very topical discussion here at DRC Mining Week. Can you tell me a bit about your views on the new mining code, please?
Well, Chantal, my views are very public, as you know. And I think it's... I think the conversation and first day of the conference was very interesting, because I think there was a general conclusion that the whole objective of the new mining code was to raise revenues. And I think this is, what we've seen in the DRC is a massive progress since 2002 in the mining industry, but largely on in Katanga, first of all, and based on exploiting already known assets. What hasn't been discussed at all is what about exploration, new projects, attracting new investments? It's all about trying to squeeze more money out of the current investors, those brave investors that came to this country by invitation. And I think there's a general consensus that there is a crisis in town. And we need leadership both within the industry and from the politicians to work together, as has been done before during the review of the mining charters in 2005, the revisitation in 2009. There was another revisitation, and also it's about attracting big investment needs trust . And that, we need to reinforce that as an industry, as a country, that needs to be taken seriously.
Okay. There is still some work to do with the mining charter, and there is some serious negotiation that still needs to take place. But Randgold was one of those investors that were here from the start. So as I understand, Kibali is at the point of coming into production after a really long construction period. Can you tell me a bit more about Kibali and where you are currently?
Yes, I think, Kibali is everything that everyone desires.
Yes.
If you listen to the government, if you discuss it with the minister, if you listen to the civil society, if you visit,
yes.
We've opened up a new frontier, which we promised the president back in 2013 when he poured our first bar of gold. It's been a 9-year exercise to bring this massive organization into production in a part of the country where there's no infrastructure. And in the same instance, we've done a lot of things like, apart from creating jobs and driving a brand new economy, regional economy. When we got there were 30,000 people in Doko, they're now 500. 500,000, that is. We built 43 schools. We've really worked hard at fulfilling our social contract. At the same time, we've given more than 5,600 families new homes, water, electricity, and we've built our own hydropower stations, and the local contractors have really benefited from our investment. And so that's really something that we're proud of, and I think it's an example for the government and other miners that you can do it in very remote places in difficult jurisdictions.
It's clear that you were very successful in bringing Kibali online, or going to bring Kibali online, and I do understand that you're still committed to the country and you're doing a lot of exploration in the DRC. Can you talk me through some of the other exploration projects that you have here?
Yes, I think, the end of the day, we are corporate citizens. The dominant percentage of our executive leadership is Congolese. It is a Congolese business. It's incorporated in Congo, Kibali, and we've taken international investors' money and we've invested it in Congo for the benefit of all stakeholders. And we meet once every 3 months, and we completely disclose everything that we do, and including the significant percentage, more than 50% of the investments we've made have been through Congolese contractors, subcontractors, and Congolese businesses. So and we're a public company committed to investing in sub-Saharan Africa gold projects, and so our job is to continue to find investments, and we see the DRC as a very important component in the future success and development of sub-Saharan Africa. And so we're a long-term game. At the same time, we are also committed partners to the state, the government, and the people of the DRC. And with that comes the responsibility to engage constructively to find workable solutions for a country that's always stalled before the people can really benefit from its natural resources.
Perfect, Mark. That was all from me. Thank you for your time today.
Thank you, Charlotte.